Lightyear, an electric vehicle startup based in the Netherlands, has unveiled the Lightyear Zero, a solar-powered electric vehicle. To many, solar-powered cars may appear ridiculous because leading electric car companies such as Tesla aren't producing them. Still, Lightyear Zero's creators are confident that their vehicles will outperform the current best electric vehicles. With its new futuristic design, Lightyear Zero has much more to offer. Aside from design, the car has a lot more to offer. Stay tuned as we get up close and candid with the Lightyear Zero. Solar panels on electric vehicles appear to be a good idea, but how much range can they provide? And is it value for your money? Stay tuned and don't touch that dial. Let's first start by looking at the history of this company. Lightyear was founded in 2016 by ex-members of Solar Team Eindhoven, a group of engineering students who won the World Solar Challenge race in 2013, 2015 and 2017 with their Stella solar cars. The Stella solar cars could generate more power from their solar panels than they consumed on average, which meant that you could finish a journey with more charge than you started. Late last year, an unexpected ray of electric car sunshine shone down. The Lightyear One is a solar-assisted electric car that can travel and even charge itself using only the sun. That car, it turns out, was a prototype, albeit a seemingly finished product. The finished product, known as the Lightyear Zero, is now available. While it visually and conceptually resembles the One, it is the sunny car expected to enter production this fall and reach initial customers by the end of 2022. Let's take a look at the design. The car is as close to a teardrop shape as any vehicle available today, with a particularly long tail. This results in a claimed drag coefficient of 0.19. It should be noted that without a standardized measuring system for drag coefficients, claimed CD figures aren't always comparable across manufacturers. Drag is further reduced by active grille shutters, flat wheel covers, and partially enclosed rear wheel wells. Its carbon fiber body, largely constructed from carbon fiber scraps recovered from other uses, contributes to its exceptionally low weight of 3,500 pounds, including 770 pounds of battery. The Lightyear Zero will also use in-wheel hub motors for the first time in a production passenger vehicle. These motors have undergone several generations of development to become smaller and lighter for their power, while also getting rid of drive shafts and other components. The Zero, like the One, has a strip of photovoltaic cells running from its snout to its boot. According to Lightyear, the Zero has a full 5 square meters of the solar array, which equates to 54 square feet, the same figure as the prototype. The tapered tadpole body shape remains unchanged, though it appears Lightyear made some minor regulatory concessions with the Zero, enlarging its headlight binnacles and reshaping some aspects of the fog lights and tail lights. The car is extremely slippery, with a claimed drag coefficient of 0.19, and it wears optional rear fender skirts to further evade the wind. According to Lightyear, the Zero loses about 7 miles of driving range per charge without the aero skirts. There are also small humps, one behind each of the front wheels. These are the rear-facing cameras that serve as side mirrors. Wheel covers improve airflow around the vehicle, and the Zero even gets a sleeker design that resembles the alloy slicer wheels on the new Chevy Silverado 1500 EV pickup. Because a relatively small 60 kilowatt-hour battery pack powers the Zero's solar array, Lightyear focused heavily on aerodynamics. According to Lightyear, an owner could go months between traditional plug-in charging sessions if their daily commute is less than 22 miles, and when not in use, they leave the car exposed to the sky. The array can add 43.5 miles of driving range per day from the sun alone. So if you start with a full battery and drive less than 43.5 miles per day, or use less than that equivalent of energy driving the car or cranking up the air conditioning or whatever, you can go quite a long time without ever reaching for a plug. As we mentioned in our first look at the Lightyear One, the solar panels act as a battery range extender. Whereas some other EVs use gas-powered range extenders, tiny generator engines that charge the battery while driving, here the solar array does the job. The aerodynamics mentioned above and the Lightyear Zero's incredibly lightweight make this job much easier. Despite its mid-size sedan plus size and battery, the mostly carbon fiber Zero weighs only 3,472 pounds, according to the automaker. Look no further than Zero's stated driving range to get an idea of the impact of its lack of mass or aerodynamic drag. According to Lightyear, the Zero can travel 388 miles on the WLTP test cycle, which is Europe's equivalent of our EPA testing, and yields slightly more optimistic range estimates. The problem is that those tests are conducted indoors, on dynamometers, away from the sun. Therefore, even if a driver covered the Lightyear's solar array and drove it around like a traditional EV wrapped in a gift, it would still have a range that challenged Tesla with only a 60 kWh battery pack. For comparison, the smaller Nissan Leaf only has an EPA estimated driving range of up to 226 miles when outfitted with its optional 62 kWh battery, which adds several hundred pounds to the vehicle's weight. The Lightyear is that light and that aerodynamic. Let us now examine the interior. The low car's sleekly raked windshield necessitates careful head positioning, but once inside, the seats are nicely shaped and very supportive. A digital instrument cluster and a separate horizontal center touchscreen are standard. However, Lightyear is still working on display graphics to present energy usage more understandably than the current list of numbers. It's as simple as pressing the D button in the row at the front of the console to get started. Every member of the Lightyear team who was interviewed stressed that the steering and accelerator mapping was not final. According to those who've test driven the vehicle, the steering was heavy and slow to respond. They also stated that the accelerator felt linear, resulting in leisurely takeoffs from a standstill. Let's see how the Lightyear Zero compares to other vehicles. Regarding performance, the Tesla and Nissan Leaf comparisons are reversed. The Lightyear Zero's range and ability to convert solar energy into power are impressive, but that power is barely enough to get the car moving. Despite having an unusual quadrant of in-wheel electric motors, Lightyear is open about the fact that the Zero will be quite slow, reaching 62 miles per hour in about 10 seconds, according to the company. Why? Each hub motor produces insignificant power. Lightyear hasn't revealed any details about the production-ready Zero's motors, but the Lightyear One prototype's four motors combined for a paltry 136 horsepower and 885 pound-foot of torque. Before you gag at that torque figure, remember that because they lack a gear reduction, which inboard motors would undoubtedly have, their accelerating force will be closer to 111 pound-foot, assuming a typical 8-to-1 driveline reduction. In other words, the doors of this thing will be blown off by a Nissan Leaf. Since efficiency is key in this situation, lowering driveline losses took precedence over straight-line speed. The Zero has the lowest driveline energy losses of any production EV, which is Lightyear's sole driveline claim. The car charges relatively quickly, largely because of its diminutive battery. The Lightyear claims that the Zero can add up to 20 miles of range per hour when plugged into a 120-volt household outlet. However, when upgraded to a public charger, which we interpret to mean a 240-volt level 2 source, that number increases to 124 miles per hour. Up to 323 miles per hour can be added by a fast charger, which we assume to be a DC quick charger. What about the sunlight? Glad you asked. It has a range of 6.2 miles per hour, which is lower than the prototype's claimed 7 miles per hour, but still impressive. The car can absorb solar energy while driving, though it will almost certainly use all of the electricity generated by the solar arrays to keep driving. Again, the solar panels are more of a range-extending feature, offsetting energy use in real time, even if the car will eventually need to be plugged in and recharged. So far, Lightyear's sales goals for the US market are unclear. Nonetheless, the Lightyear Zero is expected to be available to customers by December this year, most likely in Europe and Lightyear's home market of the Netherlands. The company says the Zero has been approved by regulators, but does not specify which regulators or where. You can order the Zero right now on Lightyear's website, but be warned, it's not cheap. While the production of Lightyear One was estimated to cost around $175,000 last year, Lightyear Zero far exceeds that figure. Lightyear lists the Zero's starting price as €250,000 before VAT. At current exchange rates, that is $265,000. With VAT, it's more than $320,000. The cost of new high technology appears to be as certain as the sun rising tomorrow. Would you drive Lightyear Zero daily? Do you think its design is appealing? Please tell us in the comments section. That being said, we get to the end of our video. Thanks a bunch for watching and stay tuned for more. Be sure to check out the videos being displayed on your screen. Until the following video, peace, I am out.